Welcome RPA champions. This video is going to be very, very cool. We are going to see how to set up web UI on our computer that is going to allow us to run OpenAI ChatGPT models or open source model or whatever kind of models. And this is so cool because we eventually don't need to depend on a API. We can depend on our own machine with our own models, and therefore we can run AI for free. But additionally to that, I'm going to show you how to install Ollama on the same machine and run models locally. But on top of that, we are also going to set up ngrok, which is going to give us a link to the machine that we have set up. So in this example, you see chat. If you've never seen this, this is web UI. This is the interface that looks just like ChatGPT, but it's running on my computer on a link that I can access from anywhere. So if you want something like this, this video is for you. We are going to see how to set up web UI, and this is this right here. So we're going to see how to set this up, web UI. We're going to see how to set up Ollama, and then we're going to set up ngrok so that we can access web UI from wherever we want. It is going to be easy. You don't have to be a developer. You can follow along with me. There is no special requirements for setting this up. So just hang in and you're going to learn something really cool, but also this is going to give you really a lot of power. Why? Because instead of using ChatGPT and paying $20 a month, you can just get the API keys and use it for as much as you consume it. Therefore, if you don't consume the full $20 of the sponsorship via API, you're going to save some money. So let's get started. So in my example, I have a virtual machine where I am running web UI and ngrok. So if you don't have a virtual machine, you can set it up on your own computer. So to set up a virtual machine, you can have a workstation that is local on premise in your environment, or you can set up a virtual machine on Google Cloud, on Azure, on AWS, and so forth. And what you have to do is install web UI. So to install web UI, it is also very simple. So let's get started installing it. We're going to go to the GitHub page, and we can download this code right here. So there's different ways of installing it. We can download the code, we can clone the Git repo, or we can just follow the instructions inside if we have Python installed. So if we don't wanna set it up with Docker, which I'm not going to be showing you how to set it up with Docker, I'm gonna be showing you how to set it up with Python. And and that's pretty much it. So there is only two commands that you are going to need once you set up a virtual environment. So that is to install the library and then to start the server. This is going to start a local server, localhost 8080, where we can access the web page after that. There is a couple of things that you should keep in mind, that if you're using graphic cards on your machine, and if you need to configure that, Docker already pre-comes with pre-configured configuration for running different versions or different optimized versions of web UI. However, you can do the same in the configuration of Ollama. I'm going to show you how to download and install next. So just make sure that you have Python version 3.11 installed. That is one of the requirements that we need. So if we also go onto the documentation page and we go into the getting started guide and we go into the quick start, and right here we have all different kinds of ways that we are going to can install this. I'm going to be choosing Python and virtual environment. So in this example, they're showing you that you need to type in Python 3 if that is how you set it up in your path. But in my example, it's just Python -V, and then you create a folder, a virtual environment. After that, you activate that virtual environment, you installed Open Web UI, and then you launch the server. Let me show you what that looks like on the workstation. So right here, I have it running already. So this is giving you a detailed log of everything that is happening, all of the API calls or all of the calls that are made to your model. So we are going to stop it with Control and C. I'm already inside of a virtual environment, but if I wanted to create a new virtual environment, I would just create a new folder here, and I don't even need to download the code. I can just install it via the command line. But before installing it, just make sure to, let's find it right here. Here it is. To activate your virtual environment, it depends on what kind of machine you're running, Windows or Mac, is going to be a different command. And once it's activated, you can run the, let's see what is the command that we need to run. We can run this command right here. This command is going to start it, on this machine. So this is really great because it is just like ChatGPT, it is much more powerful, meaning that it allows for code generation using different models, generating images, doing a web search, managing accounts. And now I'm going to show you a little bit of a walkthrough, how to configure it, how to set it up with different functionalities so that you get really the most out of this. So it is still starting. And remember, this is an open source project that keeps on updating. So there's going to be updates very often. And to update it, it's really easy. You can either do it via code, or there is a functionality inside of the interface that is going to allow you to update it without even using the code. Once it is ready, we can go on our local machine and just type in localhost 8080. So as soon as the server has started, we can access this server. Now I am the admin of this page, and in here, now I cannot see it because of the webcam, but we can see that in here we have this option right here, and right here we can configure all kinds of different configurations for this to use. So for example, we can configure image generation. Right now I'm using the OpenAI API with DALL-E 3 for image generation, but you can use also Confi installed on your own machine as well. Then we can see also, I want to show you all of the different models that we can use. So I added the OpenAI and DeepSeek APIs, plus I'm using Ollama locally to run local models. So I'm using OpenAI, all the different models from OpenAI, not just restricted to the ones that they give you on the Pro plan. And also I'm using DeepSeek, but I can also add Claude and whatever provider I want to get their models as well. And then if I want to use these models inside of my chat, is as simple as activating them. So I can choose all of these different models, and we have some really advanced models. So for example, that are on a limit on a Pro plan. So for example, if we get a Pro plan from ChatGPT, we are on a limit for using, let's see it, deep search. There's somewhere a deep search preview, turbo preview. Well, right now I cannot find it, but somewhere in here, there we go. Mini search preview, not this one. 4.0 search preview. Yeah, one of these is also used for real-time preview, no, search preview. So this is a deep search. This is a model that you don't have access to via the chat. You have deep search, but deep search is limited only to a certain amount of tries every month, just like any other model. And if you use it, you run out of it. Here, whatever you use, you pay for via API, so it can be less, it can be more. But you can also control what kind of models, the expensive ones, the cheap ones, and so forth. And also you can use your own models. So that is what I'm going to show you how to do next. This is also going to be really easy, just like setting up web UI. It's actually going to be really easier. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to Ollama and we are going to download and install it. It is just a click install. There is no special configuration that you need for it. Once it is installed, you're going to see something, if you're on Windows, something like this that is running. Very minimal. You can't even have an interface or anything. However, the way that you work with it is via terminal. So in any kind of terminal, you can open the command line, you can go to your Visual Studio, run the terminal, and you can interact with Ollama. So what are some of the things that you need to do. So if you're using multiple graphic cards, you have to configure the different graphic cards in the configuration or create a special file for each one of the models. But before we even go there, the first thing that we have to do is we just have to download a model. That is also very easy to do. We're going to go to models, choose the model that we want to use. So for example, Gemma 3 is a pretty weak model, meaning that you need, it's a very good model, but it requires only one GPU. So all that we have to do is just copy this command right here, select the model that we want to use, the 3 GB, the 8 GB, the 17 GB, and the more gigabytes it has, the more RAM you're going to use. If you're running like 16 gigabytes of RAM, I would suggest that you use a 4 billion model, maybe maximum, maybe a 12 billion, but that is going to start running already a little bit slow. However, this model is supposed to be very powerful and supposed to require only one graphic card. So that is pretty much it. You are going to select all of the models that you want to download locally, and after that you are going to just put them inside of the terminal and download them with this way. What is going to happen is you're just going to, like, I downloaded this model right here, Ollama pool, and I downloaded this model. So to run it afterwards in the terminal, you would run the Ollama run Gemini 3. Once you have installed Ollama, you're going to go back to the web UI interface, and you're going to make sure that inside of the connections, you are connected to the localhost. This is the default connection for the Ollama. Make sure to know in the logs on which port you are running so that you connect to the right one. However, after different installations, the port has always been the same. It's difficult that this port is already occupied, so this is going to be the link. Once you connect to your Ollama, you're going to have access to all of the different models that you have downloaded. So in this example, I downloaded Code Llama, I downloaded DeepSeek Optimized Latest, DeepSeek R1, R1 1 billion, 70 billion, and other models like Quen, and I think I also have Gemma somewhere around here. So that's how we set up this. There is also lots of great functionalities that allow you to manage different users that can connect to this. You can create different chatbots, different instruction chatbots, create different knowledge bases, but this for a later video if you would like me to go into more detail. For right now, let's get the basic installation down and have everything set up. So right now that you're running this server on your machine, you can also do something like you can run the control panel, or you can run the terminal, and you can type in something like, let's go right here, we can type in something like ipconfig. So what is this? Oh, ipconfig. This is going to give us our local IP address. Now, if we take this IP address and we share it with anybody on our network, so all the computers that are inside of our local LAN or inside of our home with other computers, like from our from the other people that connect, if we give them this link, just replacing localhost, we should be able to access this server. Now, the first time you access it, you're going to if you are the first time that you're running it, it's going to ask you to create an account, and you're going to create an admin account. But for everybody else, it's going to give them the ability to register, and we are going to fill out like some name, something like this. Whatever, it doesn't really matter, and some random password. Okay, so I cannot access because this is I need to be the admin, so I'm going to just change right here, going to go to localhost where I'm already enabled, and I'm going to go into the admin panel, and there's really loads of things that you can configure. It's such a great platform. So I see here a new user that has been created. I'm going to enable him, and then if I go back here, I can just refresh, and now I am in here with as a new user that has no chats right here, and has only the models available to new users. So from the control panel, you can also control what models are available. So if I go here to a new chat, the admin can see all of the other chats, all of the different models that can be used. However, a normal user cannot. So this is how we would use it inside of our local network. And the last thing that I want to show you is how we would then connect from any link anywhere in the world to our machine. So if this is a virtual machine, if this is a workstation, if this is our own computer that we want to just keep on running and access it, it is going to be also very easy. What we're going to do is we're going to go to ngrok. We're going to create an account right here so that we can get the API key. After that, we're going to download ngrok. So to download ngrok, it is also very simple. Let's go see where the command that is used to download it. I have just set it up right now. So let's see. Right here, we would set it up in PowerShell. If you're having any issues installing it, you should search for PowerShell, run as admin, and then run this command that I'm going to show you right now. So this is going to be the command I'm going to show you right now. Choco install ngrok. This is going to install ngrok on your computer. And after that, what you have to do is you have to add your authentication token. This token right here, I'm going to change it. Obviously, all of this I'm going to change after this video. You have to add this to your authentication file, and that will allow you to launch ngrok. Once ngrok is running, in this example right here, so to launch it, we used Choco install, but then we had an issue. We needed to be admin, so we installed it via PowerShell. After it has been installed and we added our token, we're going to get a link that looks just like this. And if we click on this link, or if we copy this link and then I go back to my desktop and just open this link in a new page, we're going to be redirected to our server. Now, right here, I am also as a new user on our server. I can use all of the models that have been enabled for this user, and I can even create images, do web searches, and so forth. So let's use, for example, DeepSeek version R1, and let's perform a web search on tell me what is going on in the US today. Even though I don't live in the US, I'm still interested in knowing what is going on. So we see that it has the date quite right. It's got the current events. We're using a local model with the web search enabled, and it is really great. So I don't depend on ChatGPT, on their pro plan, on their any kind of plan. And I'm also not limited to their models. I can use my own models for free. I can use also ChatGPT, DeepSeek, Claude Anthropic, and whatever else I want. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you have stuck with me for so long, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because I make this kind of videos that help you automate your things, give you an edge in AI, because an edge in AI is what is required right now before they completely take over. So, ladies and gentlemen, like the video, leave me a comment down below, tell me what kind of videos you want to see, and I will see you in the next one.